Dude, what if it wasn't you? What if it were someone else? What if that person didn't have access to lawyers, to the media? What do you think would have happened?
I know the answer to this question, Carmina, because we've met people inside the jail who are that kind of people. No, they're not me. And they've been jailed and they're languishing in jail. There was one person who had to stay in locked up for 8 months before his case got dismissed, but it was obviously a bogus case. No, there is someone there who has been inside for 5 years. No, he was locked up when he was 18, just because he had the same body type as the person that they were looking for, and he's still inside, no, for 5 years. This is what happens to ordinary people. I really think the same thing happened to us because they didn't know who we were, know that we were ordinary in their eyes when they saw us, and they thought that they could do the same thing. But apparently, you know, it was also a surprise to me, know that people are interested, know, and people care. And this is such a one of the biggest things that I cannot say thank you enough, know, to the people who supported and to the media, know that they were actually interested and that they actually cared. That justice, that real justice, should prevail, no? And there was attention towards us that it made things a bit faster. 40 days is already a long time, but it's comparatively, you know, relatively faster than anyone else that I've met inside the jail cell.
I guess it's now an opportune time to say this, Jade. It's easy to sort of romanticize what had happened to you because it's you, because there's access to the media, to lawyers. It was part of the news cycle, right? For the 40 days that you were there. But the thing that we should stress is that this is reality for many
Right.
other people.
Right. And that's what we are hoping for, because so my friends and I were there. We had a lot of time to talk inside the jail, of course. Now we were together. We were saying that this is taking too long. At first, all we really wanted to do was to get out. No, but then we said, no, this should have a purpose. We think that this kind of experience, what happened to us, with this wrong that happened to us, maybe should have a purpose. And that's why we think that we need to do something, you know, and use this experience to help maybe create change, you know, to maybe shed light on what is wrong about what's going on in the system, that so that maybe in the future things like this would not happen to ordinary people.
I want to talk to you about your parents. How are they doing?
Oh, I love my parents. They've been there all the time, literally. My parents decided to stay in Catanawan while I was there in jail. No, they looked for a place to stay, and there were good people in Catanawan, no, who offered help and offered a place to stay for my parents, and they were there all the time. There were limited visiting hours, but you know, my mom, lagi niyang sinasagad yung oras, no? just so that we could be together, no? And I knew she was doing it so that I would not feel like I was alone. My
You,
parents now are.
yeah. Sorry to cut you there, Jade, because we're running out of time. I mean, you talk to us in a very jovial way. I mean, I can see that you're really just happy being out. But is there anger? Is there anger when you talk when you talk about your parents? Do you feel anger, and what are you going to do about it?
Yes, there is anger because there is an injustice that happened, and it should not have happened to us. There is definitely anger. If I sound jovial, it's really just because of the way I am. It's really just my personality, you know. You talk to anybody that I worked with, you know, on set, that it's really a fun set whenever I'm the director, you know? But yes, there is anger. I really wish that this did not happen to my family, you know, that they all the sacrifices that they made, you know, which is why we are still talking about what the next steps are supposed to be, you know, what we should be doing, because it doesn't really stop here, you know. Getting out doesn't really end with just getting out, you know. Something else needs to be done, and we don't know what that is yet, you know. We're still talking about it, but hopefully someday.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. We've run out of time. Jade Caster there joining us this noon. Jade Caster is, of course, a filmmaker who was detained, put it behind bars for some 40 days, and now he's free. And now he's saying there's got to be some change and there's got to be a purpose behind what's happened to him. Thank you so much for joining us, and I wish you the best, and I wish you luck.
Thank you, Carmina.
Take care.